Should you take me from this darkness left inside? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Ring of Honor. We had a little break. We took a step back from a little bit. Had to let Impact Wrestling shine for a little bit, catch up on the episode numbers. But we're now back. We're in St. Louis, Missouri, Randy Orton's hometown, what it is. And yeah, man, we're back. Re-debut show, if you will. And here comes Mr. Eric Bischoff. I'm about to lay down the law. If you didn't know, Eric Bischoff is the GM for Ring of Honor Wrestling. So Stone Cold and Eric Bischoff working again together. Working together again since the days of like the Ruthless Aggression era in like 2003-04 where they were co-general managers. That was fun, wasn't it? But anyway, here we go. Let's see what Bischoff has to say. Not exactly likable. It is the future of our business. This is where superstars are going to be made, man. Trust that. You've seen the names that came from Ring of Honor there. Sami Zayn, Samoa Joe, CM Punk, Daniel Bryan, all them lot came from Ring of Honor Wrestling, man. Okay. I like the tournament situation. They're fun. Cute. Okay, Eric Bischoff with the clean announcement. Having a little bit of a tournament on Ring of Honor Wrestling here to decide who will go to final battle to face off against CM Punk. Very interesting, and obviously we're gonna have to kick off the show with the cruiserweight action. That's how Eric Bischoff likes and does. And we've got the Hurricane. Hurricane is officially signed with WCW and Ring of Honor, so we'll be on both shows as with all cruiserweights. And yeah, man. It's a big addition to the Cruiserweight division, a bit of strength in numbers. Obviously, Hurricane has been a previous Cruiserweight champion, has been a European champion, has been a World Tag Team champion. Hurricane been up in the mix. He's been up in the mix, man. Guy's got himself a little career, so having him here on Ring of Honor in the Cruiserweight division, definitely a big addition, definitely a big name, a big star to boost this division up a little bit, if you know what I'm trying to say. And he will be going up against the new Cruiserweight champion, Rey Fénix. Man, Rey Fénix was successful at Bash of the Beach in winning the Cruiserweight Championship. Probably wasn't a name you'd picture with the Cruiserweight Championship before the event started. But afterwards, everyone in the locker room, everyone in the back, all the fans around the world had to accept that Rey Fénix is the new and the second ever Cruiserweight champion for WCW/Ring of Honor. But yeah, if you didn't watch WCW this past week, it's in the playlist. And Neville became the number one contender for Rey Fénix's Cruiserweight Championship. So at Survivor Series, it will be Rey Fénix versus Adrian Neville for the Cruiserweight Championship. And that is going to be a match for the ages. I can already see it being one of the matches of this universe mode, like one of the best matches we've seen. But yeah, let's focus on the action here. The ring, referee rings for the bell later on in the match. My boy smacked him, just and drew it. A reverse hurricanrana, that's just lethal, man. It's just lethal. It is. Goes for the pin. 1, 2, Rey Fénix. Oh, Hurricane stays alive, getting the shoulder up just before the 3 count. And Rey Fénix can't believe his eyes. Cruiserweight champion trying to put in a dominant performance here. But boy, I see Hurricane was going for the right hand of his own, and you forearm smash the face, and not my boy with these right hands. You need to calm it down a little bit. The Rey Fénix just plotting my boy dead. Look at him, that leg was just dangling off the roof. That bitch said, bitch, I'm done, I can't move. And Rey Fénix successfully picks up the victory in this match here. Dominant performance by the new Cruiserweight champion, and I'm pretty sure Adrian Neville is looking on in the back, or wherever he is, and keeping a close eye on the Cruiserweight champion, scouting the moves, scouting what, how and what he does in the ring. It's going to be a great match at Survivor Series, but we've still got 3 weeks ahead of us before we even get there. So we'll see. It's going to be interesting to see how Adrian Neville hits back at this. And yeah, man, I'm excited. I think we're all excited to see what happens with these two at Survivor Series. But anyway, moving on. Fuck them hoes, and hit her from the back. Back. Then you put her up against the wall, and then you lift her legs over your shoulders, and then you just go in and you keep going. In, and you don't stop until she feels it in her star. Oh my gosh, what a way to open up the tournament. That's Oi, nah, that's a great way to open up the tournament. I don't care. Fuck all you haters, my boys. I told you this show's not PG. We don't do PG around here. So, I'm sorry if there were any kids. Oh, anyway, we got Shane Dawn. Oh, my days. Nah, I can't even take that song seriously anymore. I just remixed that whole shit. Oh, my gosh. Alright, now let's. I can't breathe. Wait, later on in the match, Shane Thorn had the submission locked in. And, I mean, Fandango could have easily put his legs on the rope. Easily. Just avoided that whole situation of trying to escape. And you put his legs on the rope. My boy tried to do styles and spectaculars, going for a pin and reversal. But Shane Thorn does kick out. The Shane Thorn. Oh, my boy's going for that forearm and the punch in the face there. And goes, oh, float over DDT. Down! That DDT just planted him down. And Shane Thorne's waiting for him to get up. Oh, the kick. My boy's dead. You see the way that boy, bitch's head just swiftly just died. His neck just left his whole chest. And that is it. You saw the head pause. Just drip. It was a really intense match. I can't even lie to you. If you not saw this match, it went on for a good, I'm not even lying to you, a good 20 minutes. This match, no one wanted to kick out. No one wanted to die. Like, everyone just went to kick out. Both Fandango and Shane Thorne just literally just took back some shoulder up. Like, so, Shane Thorne qualifies, man. He goes through to the next round. So, yeah, man, congratulations to him. And Fandango, I'm really sorry about your theme song. I done remixed that whole thing, and it's just not PG anymore. But anyway, make sure y'all go check out Impact Wrestling. Be on Thursdays or Fridays. You can see the likes of Austin Aries, The Rock, Johnny Gargano, Tommaso Ciampa. We've got Asuka down there. We've got Naomi. We've got Tamina Snuka. Stardust is down there. A couple mans is down there. The Ascension. Good superstars to bring up forward to SmackDown Live. Some which I believe should already be on SmackDown Live. Austin Aries. Obviously, Austin Aries was a former WCW superstar and was in the main event and then got drafted to SmackDown Live, got sent to development. I ain't gonna talk about SmackDown Live anymore on this. And the arena's got pitch black, you know. And here comes one half of Sanity right now. Sanity and the club have been going at it for a week. How you name him Alexander Wells? Production. What's going on? Alexander, what? Oh, I've got laughing giggles today, man. Actually, I even had laughing giggles. It was literally just Fandango's theme song. That killed me. I don't know what I was doing. I don't know why I decided to remix that song in that manner. But it happened. But anyway, let's just focus back. Because I'm about to laugh again. Alexander Wolf, man. Got put up here tonight. Against one member of the Bullet Club. As I said, these two have been going out for quite a while. And I think they're ready to just end one. The show's not big enough for the both of them. Someone's gonna have to die, and someone's gonna have to take this L. As a faction, as a team, as a movement, But my boy Paige is walking down to the ring with some authority. He is not, look at him. He is ready. He's not playing. He only got one goal in mind, and that's probably what flipping Adam Cole has told him in the back. You just kill everything in your path when you go out in that ring, because Alexander Wolf is no joke. He's no joke. He's a beast. He's got a big size on him. Pause on that. Oh my day. Nah, pause.
This episode.
This got to be the most non-PG episode I've ever done in my entire life doing Universe World commentaries. It ain't been that long. It's been about 8 months. So I'm apologizing for that. My boy, that was beautifully executed. What a suplex. You see it, Alexander Wolf, my boy is legit. And he goes for the pin here. Referee in position. Ooh, Paige kicks out. Paige stays alive. Alexander Wolf misses with a swift kick, and Paige gets out of the way, and that neck break, oh my lord, just drilled that head. I had to check just to see where the finishes were going with this, because sometimes the game drops. Oh, you! Oh, Paige, I see you. I see you. And he's waiting for Wolf to get up. Wolf gets to his feet here, and Paige got him over his shoulders. I don't know what this is called, but goodness me! They're dead. That was dead. That was a dead finisher. It is not lit. It was dead. But he gets a pin. And that's one over up on Sanity by the Bullet Club. They obviously came short at Field of Honor. But I guess then they're making their movements to end Sanity at Final Battle. And Paige is on the outside. And Alexander Wolf, there's no sign of the Elite or the Bullet Club. There's no sign of Sanity right now. Oh my lord, decapitating Alexander Wolf. Look at the size difference between these two. Adam Page is literally destroying. Look at the right hands. Oh my goodness me, Alexander Wolf is getting destroyed right now. Throw him into the barricade, and Adam Page is laying in wait with the right hands. Goodness me, the referee talking about some stop. Oh my god, no, don't do this, bitch. You need to get in between these two. Pause. And I think Wolf is knocked out. I think Wolf is done. I think Wolf is done in the clothesline. Again, no Sanity, no. The club isn't here. And the spit that just left my mouth and went on my windshield. Microphone shit. Oh my gosh, my commentaries are so weird. I don't focus on the matches. I just say whatever. But you about to pay for what you just did, Paige. You about to pay for that. That ain't gonna go unnoticed by Sanity. Trust me. It's peak for you. Anyway, make sure you check out the Peasanty Show SmackDown Live. Day is on Wednesdays. Some lit superstars: Nakamura, Apollo Crews, Baron Corbin, Bray Wyatt, AJ Styles, Dolph Ziggler, Finn Balor, The Undertaker, Kane, Triple H, Bobby Roode. Yeah, it's a place where it's a place for the superstars, but they ain't all being used, and they ain't being used correctly, so they trash in my eyes. So just gonna let that one slide. Anyway, second Ring of Honor Championship tournament match. Here comes your boy Bram, man. Bram is legit. Bram is all about embracing your evil side, bringing out the side of That everyone has within them. He believes that everyone has that kind of dark, evil, satanic, you know, I want to kill you sort of side. And that's what Bram is about, man. That's what he does. That is what he lives for. That's what he stands by. And just by him coming down the ring, you can see just the intensity in his eyes and the evilness within his eyes. He's only got one thing in mind: kill everything in your path. I feel like that's the theme of this episode right now. Actually, no, the theme of this episode is just non-PG, straight up. But he's facing off against this man, Sheamus, who debuted at SummerSlam, was up in the mix for the WCW World Championship, kind of dropped out, decided he wanted to come down to Ring of Honor, where the superstars are being made. He wants to make presence known here, just like Rusev did, just like CM Punk did. I mean, there ain't no shame sometimes in downgrading. There ain't no shame. So, you know, with Austin Aries, I can understand, but Sheamus is going to make his way up, just as CM Punk has done, just as Rusev has done. And there ain't no problem with that. So here he is. Sheamus on Ring of Honor. And and this could be his one-way ticket to getting the Ring of Honor Championship. CM Punk has been Ring of Honor Champion since day one, has not lost the championship since, and has won successful title defense under his belt. But the competition in this tournament is very, very high and very fierce. And when you got two monsters like this, Bram or Sheamus coming at you, he's about to go the opposite way. But CM Punk has faced a beast himself, man. He's faced off against Rusev. He's faced off against Bram in the past as well. So I think he's familiar with facing off against the brutality and strength of a big person or a big superstar such as these two here. Sheamus hit that Celtic cross there, and he's waiting for it. Pat in the chest. I think we know what's coming next. Bam! You about to get decapitated! The bro kick. Oh my lord! It's a wrap. The shoulders are down. Referee's in position, and that's a three count. Sheamus is going through, and we'll be taking flipping Shane Thorne in 2 weeks' time on Ring of Honor television. I mean, I expected Bram to probably cut him out. If you just see the way I smacked my own lip with this windshield microphone thing, you would literally love. I need to get my webcam soon, because some of the shit I do on commentary, the way I am, it's just funny. Like, well, I think it's funny. Y'all don't think it's funny, but I think it's funny. I'm moving my microphone. I'm moving this windshield shit because it's not staying with the shit where it was before with the shit. So now I have to keep moving the shit. So you're probably hearing the microphone a bit with the shit, and I am sorry. But Sheamus is about to attack Bram. He's picking him up. Sheamus, listen, you don't have to do this. You don't have to do it like this, man. You can just walk away like a normal civilized human. But wait a minute. Sheamus kind of showing Bram a sign of respect a little bit, picking him up, and he's just walking away. My boys. Okay. Well, cool. What's up with the loading? What's going on? I mean, I don't know what Sheamus just did there. I don't know what his intentions were or the thought process was, but Sheamus literally just picked up Bram, looked him in the eye, and just cut. Just left. Just left. I don't know, y'all. But here comes the Ring of Honor television champion. You know, my boy Kirsten didn't even know. Cause I know he didn't watch Field of Honor. That's why he didn't know. But he didn't know that Marty Scurll won the TV championship in the Battle Royale, the biggest match on the show. And somehow he's like, I didn't see it. I didn't see it. I was like, because you didn't watch it, my boy. You didn't watch it. And here comes the Ring of Honor World Champion. This Mark Trucker been putting in performances after performances after performances. This Mark Trucker, do you think this Mark Trucker ready for a call up? I do. I think CM Punk is ready. But before that can even happen, if it even happens, he's got to go to Survivor Series and defend the Ring of Honor World Championship against who? I don't know. We'll have to find out who wins this tournament in the next coming weeks. But I don't think CM Punk realizes that he has revived his career. Like, the way this Montreal came down to Ring of Honor, won the Ring of Honor Championship, and has just literally just been this presence in Ring of Honor, like a brother figure, and just a mentor and a leader in the locker room, CM Punk has become. And that's where he wanted to be, man. That's where he wanted to be in WCW, and he realized he wasn't going to be that yet, so decided to come down to Ring of Honor instead of working in WCW, and has successfully held that Ring of Honor Championship for, I think, the last 3 months, or I think it's 3 months. Oh! Marty Scurll, I see you with that kick out of nowhere. CM Punk wasn't ready for it. I was certainly not ready for it. Y'all was not ready for it, because your ears should pop if you got headphones in, because that kick was lethal. And Marty Scurll going for that power driver. Oh my goodness me! Oh, CM Punk is done. CM Punk is done. CM Punk, oh, the ropes just saved the soul of CM Punk. And now he's busted open, the open wound, and Marty Scurll's been busted open previously in this match as well, man. That wound is open, the blood is pouring down his face. CM Punk making his way to his feet, and the right, oh no, CM Punk with the reversal, and he goes, oh, wait a minute. We know what's coming next. He's on the shoulders, go to sleep. Oh, perfectly executed. He got all of it. Go for the pin. And the Ring of Honor World Champion dominating the TV champion, as he should do. and that's an impressive win under CM Punk's belt. Another victory that solidifies CM Punk's legacy here on Ring of Honor, man. This guy has been here for years. This is where he started. This is where he's come back to regain his... Oh, wait a minute! Why is this motherfucker here? You do not have a title match with CM Punk anymore. You're out of the title picture. What are you doing? What is going on? Rusev! Oh, Rusev and the referee on the outside. Bitch, if you're going to try and stop something, get in the ring and get in between the superstars. Don't be talking about on the outside. Stop. Oh, my God. Rusev is out here again, and we saw this before Field of Honor. Rusev continuing the attacks after the match, and he misses that kick. CM Punk goes for the clothesline, missing the clothesline. He misses the spin heel kick, and Rusev missing the kick again. And CM Punk finally lays a slap, but Rusev reverses it with the left hand and now going for a right hand. And CM Punk with the right hand of his own. My God, these two just hate each other, don't they? Flipping. Now, I think I'm going to have to put him in like a head in the cell sign because this is ridiculous. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh no, Rusev! Oh my goodness me. Rusev finally planting down CM Punk. Oh no, we've seen this before. The camel clutch is locked in. Oh my gosh, CM Punk is tapping, but there's nothing you can do. Oh my God, again. We have to sort out what's wrong with Rusev because this man is on a roll. I'm going to have to see y'all next week for WCW. Take care of yourselves. Been a pleasure. Subscribe and all them good stuff. I'll see you next week. Peace.